How far is this one in, Fred?
About a quarter of a mile. Quite a game trail there.
Fred Thomas and Don Karsh aren't just out for a stroll. They're following in the footsteps of Henry Perkins, who came through what's now the Willamette National Forest back in 1884. Henry left something behind.
Where is it? Who's got the wire brush, Mike?
Perkins says he set a basalt stone 14 by 14 by 4. Yeah, there should be 5 notches there on that east edge.
Boy, they're hard to see. Here they are, right there. See that one? I'll be darned.
Okay, so a rock isn't exactly hidden treasure, but it's exactly what Fred and Don are after. They're land surveyors, just like Henry Perkins before them. And this rock is basically an old-fashioned survey post.
The corner point's right there.
20.3?
20.3.
Survey posts, or rocks, identify what surveyors call section corners, which are what all land ownership is built upon, whether it's in the city or out here in the middle of the woods.
Yeah, looking good, Fred.
Surveyor Tim Kent says our lives depend on maintaining something on the ground that tells us who owns what.
Sadly to say, in the United States, there's probably 2 to 3 people a year that are killed over property boundary lines. Latest one was just a couple weeks ago in Georgia, where 2 people had been arguing over where they thought their boundary was. A surveyor could have come in and established that line for them, but they didn't hire a surveyor. They said, this is mine, and finally came out, and one guy just shot the other.
Out here, a misidentified corner can mean the difference between trees cut down in a timber sale or protected in the adjacent wilderness. In town, it could mean whether the fence you put up is on your property or your angry neighbor's. Don and Fred's job is to replace old corners with new posts, but they'll stay true to the precise location of the original rock.
Regardless if the surveyor made a measurement error, those original survey corners hold. They are gospel.
So how were the first corners established? Well, essentially a grid was placed over a map of Oregon, with each square representing 1 square mile. Surveyors in the 1800s actually hiked into every corner of every square mile on the ground, no matter how deep in the wilderness, and they marked the corner with a rock or a post. Then, to make sure the corner could be found again, they kept written logs, and they etched clues into nearby trees.
We're looking at the northeast bearing tree here. It's been chopped into since the original surveyor, but in here you can see the original scribing. And then what they did was they cut a face into the tree, and then they used the scribing tool to put numbers and letters, which referenced the position they were in.
These cryptic letters and numbers, amazingly, they spell out this corner's location relative to another stone, hundreds of miles and a mountain range away. That stone is called the Willamette Stone, and it's the starting point for all surveys in Oregon and Washington. It lies at the end of a dead-end trail in Portland's West Hills.
This is the Willamette Stone. This is the base of the original stone. It was set in the 1880s. So here is the Willamette Meridian. That's your north-south. Here's the baseline. That runs east-west. If you own land in either state, this is where it's described from. This is the starting point for all surveys.
All right. Hope you guys know where you're going.
It's an ongoing chore to make sure survey monuments don't disappear over time.
Go ahead.
Fred and Don call it perpetuating the corners. It's not a bad job, usually.
Boy, there's fish jumping everywhere out here this morning. Let's go where that big trout jumped up there. Looks like a good spot to search.
There's a lot of times we're out here that people in the office go, oh, you guys got the best job in the world, and they want to be out because it's 80 degrees and sunny. There's a number of times Fred and I have been out here that's snowing and raining, 15 degrees. It's miserable. We don't get too many volunteers to come out on those days.
But that still doesn't compare to what it was like for the first surveyors who traveled through the Oregon wilderness back in the 1800s.
This one group camped out overnight, and a bunch of the natives came down with war paint, and they didn't know what was going to happen. And the chief came down. He had to talk to his braves and really work hard to keep them from coming down at night and killing all of them.
It's remarkable, really, that the early surveyors didn't just cut and run.
Well, this is looking pretty promising. There's a spruce right there, Fred.
But there were exceptions.
Good possibility right there.
Well, there's a little something there, but it's not that good, and it's not really marked quite right the way they usually do. So it's probably not a blaze.
Today, GPS guides Don and Fred to where one corner should be. but it doesn't add up with the old survey's description.
Do you have the notes, Don?
Yeah.
Does he say when we start to descend?
We're looking for a spruce, 9-inch diameter, north, 67 east, 18-inch hemlock, almost due west. I'm gonna swing north a little bit more, see if I can pick up a blaze.
I don't feel anything that feels like anything underneath here. I think this guy wasn't as thorough as he could have been, like he missed the bearing to the bearing tree. We've been where he's called a spruce, where it's actually a noble fir. So I don't think he did the best job.
This corner seemingly disappeared without a trace, and no one could say for sure why. Sometimes surveyors got lazy. In a few cases, old surveyors filed reports about corners they never actually marked. But sometimes original corners disappear for more innocent reasons.
Here we are in a campground in the National Forest, and right over here is a section corner that was set by Henry Perkins back in 1884. A bunch of kids had built a rock fort up in there, and there's a few rocks still laying there. Probably one of those might be the original stone.
Through Mother Nature, either road building or kids hiking out in the woods and finding something, that, hey, that looks kind of cool, and picking up a stone and carrying it away. We are losing more corners than we are gaining.
By using computers, GPS, and modern maps, Don and Fred can usually reestablish lost corners without much problem.
Where is it?
Which begs the question, how was this done before GPS? Well, early surveyors had to lug around one of these.
This is the original box for the Young & Sons solar compass, a compass that was first made in 1836. Ooh, there it is. And most of the public land states were surveyed with a solar compass. In the hands of a mathematician, it's the best machine ever invented to retrace a line. In the hands of an ignoramus, it gives you the wildest answers ever. You can just see a little piece of that sun there, and I'm looking through this slit and through this slit. It gives me an extension of, I don't have an edge. Oh, there, I have an edge.
We didn't exactly understand it, but
it's tracking between those lines right there.
Surveying back in the 1800s was obviously a complicated and slow process.
So that forms the triangle. See the triangle?
Yet it was also surprisingly accurate for the time.
And there's true north. Get out there and start cutting. That brush is in the way, okay? That's what you would do.
A little bit too far.
Surveying tools are definitely more high-tech now. The wilderness a little less wild than it once was. But surveying today is just as essential to property rights and to property ownership as it ever was.
Outstanding.
For that reason, you can find Fred and Don out in the woods trekking, searching, and measuring on any given day.
And this is the fun stuff.
And they take pride in keeping surveying's traditions alive.
I prefer the more traditional scribing. It's a legacy that the early surveyors started, and I think it's one that we should continue. They didn't have the comforts that we had, and they didn't have the tools that we had, and yet they did some incredible, accurate work. For me, being out in the woods, being able to hike in some of this incredible country versus sitting at a desk has always appealed to me. Just following in the original footsteps of those surveyors that were out here 100 years ago just fascinates me. Oh, looking good, Fred.
Great people just doing their thing in their own northwesty way. We love bringing you stories like this. Support what you love. OPB.org/video.